and welcome to my first recorded Pokemon pack opening. If you've made it to my channel, my name is Actionpantz, and I have been collecting Pokemon cards once again for the last 1 or 2 months. I was around when the base set released in 1999 and collected for a few years at that time, and then kind of fell out with it. I have recently started collecting again and decided that it might be fun to record the pack openings and upload them to YouTube and see if anybody shares my interest. So today we have a random assortment. We've got some Brilliant Stars, single and sleeve booster packs. I'm gonna open those, and then also some Shining Fates, which are two of the sets more recently that I've decided to try and collect the entire lot in a binder. So I'm gonna go ahead and start with the Brilliant Stars. Hoping to pull some of the cool full arts and round out my collection here. I've got a couple Vault X binders started, and I'm trying to fill those out and complete them all. Code card. Let me do the card trick. Alright, Fire Energy. Morgrem. Claydol. Got an Exeggutor. Trapinch. Cast Form. Throw. Shroomish. Piplup. Pot Helmet Reverse Holo. And an Alchemy Non Holo. Off to great start. Go ahead and pack number two. I have trouble opening these sometimes. Code card. Country. Move these out of the way. Alright. Energy. Alright. Charon's Care. Pachirisu, got a Kindler, Golett, Chimecho, Chimchar, Minchino, Baltoy, an Alchemy Reverse Holo, following up that non-holo just now, and a Luxray non-holo. Luxray and his line happen to be one of my favorites of all the Pokemon. Growlithe, Arcanine, and Shinx, and Luxray, that whole set, are all my favorites. Moving on to the sleeve booster packs here. Oddly enough, that one looks like it was open. Strange. Let's see what's going on in here. Code card. Got a V-Star card in there with that black. V-Star. Got a Cynthia's Ambition. Torkoal. Double Turbo Energy. A Riolu. Starly. Milcery. Carablast. Got a Clefairy. Ooh, a Full Art Ariados. That's a good one. Don't have that one currently, so that's a good one to add to the collection. And a Holo Lucario. Also a good one. I don't know about anybody who might watch this, but I'm not a particular fan of the updated holographic cards with these vertical line holograms. I like the classic moonray looking ones that was like all the little stars glowing in the background. Sleeve these up for protection. Yeah, it's a good looking card. Spider. Ariados. Oh, the next one. Strange that that pack was like open inside the sleeve. Hopefully the rest aren't like that. This one seems good. Moving on now. Alright. Yes. Set up here, if I'm starting a channel, is starting with gotta do what I gotta do. So I've got a plain black mat here. I do hope to over time expand on the setup and production value, and right now I'm not worried about putting card values in the video because I'm collecting more for the sake of collecting than so much the value, but who knows, things may change, just to keep track of those kind of things. All right, again, we have the Tropius, Roseanne's Backup, Blunder Policy, Cast Form, Throw, Shroomish, angry looking little thing, Piplup, a Turtwig, another good starter there. A Cafe Master Reverse Holo. And a Magmortar Non-Holo. Alright. See if we can get some good pulls here. I know Brilliant Stars, I chose this as one of the sets that I'd like to fully collect because it has some really good secret rares and trainer gallery and full art cards. So hopefully we get lucky with some of those there. Code card. More to the front. Alright, Fighting Energy. We got a Beartick, Fracture, Roseanne's Backup, Electabuzz, Hawlucha, a Buizel, a Gible, another one of my favorites to use in some of the games leading up to Garchomp, reverse holo cast form, and a non-holo Tornadus. I don't believe I have that one yet, so that's actually a good pull. I'm not sure if it's available in holographic, but something's better than nothing to put in the binder. So it seems to be sealed okay. Still don't know what's going on with that one, but I can now. Sweet. All right. Code card. 1, 2, 3, 4 to the front. All right. Lightning energy. We have a Sigilyph. Pachirisu. Choice Belt. A Sneasel. Clink. Spiritomb. An Axew. Impidimp. Reverse Holo Burmy, one of the most useless Pokemon to exist, in my opinion, so far. And a Holo Dusknoir. It's another good one that I don't already currently have, so I'm going to sleeve that one up real quick. And Reverse Holo Burmy. If I can grab it. Alright, so that is it for the Brilliant Stars currently, so we're going to move on now to the Shining Fates. Another pack I want to collect. Obviously, there's an amazing Charizard in this set, but also some of the Radiant cards and the various shiny Pokemon you can get are exciting. So, move on to these guys here. And on this channel here, if you do decide to follow along with me, I will be uploading like Pokemon game videos, and also I'm interested in Destiny 2, so I play that quite a bit, so we'll have some gaming videos in here and there as well, but I'll try and regularly do some pack openings to keep it interesting with the Pokemon. So we got a Steel Energy. Oh, interesting print issue there with that line. Hopefully it's only on the one card and not all the way through the pack. Alright, Cramorant. It was just that one, it looks like. Rusted Sword. Luxio, one of my favorites. Grookey, got a floating Eevee there. Morpeko, Chewtle, Nickit. Oh, look at that. One of the, I think it's called the Amazing Collection, Kyogre. I believe I already have that card, but still, it's always a good one to add. And a holo Indeedee. Go ahead and sleeve these two up here real quick. Separate pile. I like the way these ones look like paint splatters in the background, and it extends beyond the border. It's really cool. All right, next Shining Fate pack. We have that Corviknight artwork on this one. All right. And then, hopefully as time goes on, if it comes to it, maybe some classic card pack openings and things like that might be possible. Code card. Until then, some of the more recent sets, like I said, I'm trying to collect are probably what I'm going to be focusing on. We have Darkness Energy. Right, we have Ball Guy. Rusted Sword. Eldegoss. Cacnea. Cufant. Another Floating Eevee. Buizel. A Yanma. Oh, look at that. See, that's what I'm talking about. The shiny Roly-Coly. Awesome pull there. And a non-holo Zarude. Go ahead and sleeve up this shiny guy right here real quick. As part of when I got back into Pokemon cards recently, I found someone on Facebook Messenger who was trying to sell a lot that he got while he was acquiring some Magic the Gathering cards. And there were like 3,000 cards in the set, and upon sorting through them all, I found the guy had several different shiny cards from older series there, including a Charmander, a Magnemite, and a Voltorb. And there were some really good looking cards as well. All right. Code card. There we go. Four to the front. Hopefully get some more good pulls here. Fighting energy. Another Luxio to start it off. Not too bad. Alright, a Team Yell Towel. A Thwacky. Coughing. Horsey. Another Grookey. Morpeko. A Spinarak. Oh, look at that, a shiny Snom to follow it up. It's a strange looking Pokemon, I'm not going to deny that, but I will take a shiny anytime. And behind him, a non-holo Manaphy. That's alright, let's sleeve up this guy. Adding to the shiny collection, I'm alright with it. Alright, we have one last Shining Fates pack with the Charizard artwork. I and see if that gives us the luck we need to pull that shiny Charizard 4. That would be the ideal pull one day. Alright. So we have code card. 1, 2, 3, 4 to the front. Alright, psychic energy. I'm just gonna go to the back. Luxio to start off. That's 3 packs in a row. That's a Luxio behind the energy. That's kind of crazy. Team Yeltal, same order there. Thwacky. Morpeko. Cacnea. Chewtle. Spinarak. Cufant. There we go. Look at that. Full art Grimmsnarl from the Shiny Collection. That's a pretty cool one. I'm not too familiar with Grimmsnarl. Like I said, I was a little more accustomed to the original 150 Pokemon, so some of these are taking some getting used to and learning about. It's an amazing looking card, though. Behind it, we have a Professor's Research non-holo. All right, go ahead and sleeve this guy right up. All right, cool. Good one to pull in the last pack. Better than nothing. Now, that would have been the end of it, but I do have some little treats that I got myself from my local card shop. So I got some Japanese packs because they're just super fun and clean to pull. So I have 3 packs of Starbirth, which is the equivalent of Brilliant Stars. I've got 3 of the, I think it's the Eevee Heroes set. Those are cool looking. And then I decided to go ahead and get 1 of the Japanese version of the new set, Lost Origins, that just came out, just to see if there's anything cool I might pull. So I'm going to go ahead and start with the Starbirth here. Alright, keep within theme of what I've already had. I'm going to keep these separate as well. Now the production value of the Japanese cards I've always felt is nicer, and they have these easy little tear spots in the corner. I say easy as I fail it right down the side there. But I went to my local card shop, and oh, this is a nightmare. And felt I needed to support them, so I got some of these Japanese packs. Might do a booster box of them in the future for the channel. As even though they're smaller pack about, you know, quantities in each pack, they're fun to open. Alright, so we have a, what is that, a Corphish, I believe. A Chimecho, and a Riolu. A Burmy, and a Tropius, I believe, to start that first Japanese pack. I'm holding them off screen, I apologize. Move them to the side. Let's see if I can open this one. Sorry about that. A little bit easier here. Okay, maybe that's not the best way for me to open them after all. Might go back to the old way. Alright. So we have a Piplup, Sneasel, a Throw. Oh, look at that, rainbow full art. I don't know who that is, but it's a good pull. I'll take it. And then the Colosseum. All right, I'm gonna sleeve that one up. Can never complain about pulling rainbow rares. All right, put these guys back over here. Last one of the Japanese Starbirth. Let's try and open it like the normal way. Normal-ish. That's a bit better. All right. So we have an Electabuzz, Turtwig, a Gible, a Heatran, a Colosseum, and that is it for that one. Not bad, don't mind collecting the artwork for commons and uncommons in Japanese. Let's go ahead and move on now to some Eevee Heroes. Maybe it was best to open it the other way here. Chose these packs because I know that the Trainer Gallery of the Full Arts have a full set of the Eeveelutions. There are some amazing artwork to collect, so I wanted to try my shot at those. Let's see. So we have a Mudkip, a Zorua, I believe. I'm not 100% sure that is. Indeedee. Alright, that guy. A Trainer, and then looks like some sort of instruction card. We're going to go ahead and get rid of that. All right, a couple nice artworks there. On to number 2. If you did happen upon my channel and spent your time watching this video, I'd appreciate it. If you liked it and were interested in to see where this channel could go, give me a like and a follow, you know, all that good stuff, and a subscription maybe. All right, we have, I am losing my mind right here. What is this? Magcargo, I believe. Pancham, another one. Pandas are one of my favorite animals, so I really like Pancham. A Smeargle, something I never catch in Pokemon Go. All right, look at that. Holo, Florges, I believe. And then that guy. So again, another part of the problem that I have not kept up with Pokemon is that there's like 900 of them now, and I am not acquainted with all of them. It's a nice looking holo though. I like that on the Japanese ones, the edges are actually holographic as well. Hopefully one day I get a better camera mount here so I don't keep bumping into it like I do with this one. All right, last pack of the EV set. I think we get a good EV full art. That would be awesome. There's that instruction card. All right. We have a Mantine, I believe. Old Flower, Flabébé or something. Voltorb. Oh, look at that. Full art VMAX Sylveon. I will take it. It's a good card. And then another one of those? No, just similar. That's a good card. I'm going to go ahead and sleeve it. Sylveon is one of the cuter of the Eeveelutions. I personally have always been a Flareon fan. It's a shame, though, that the shiny version of Flareon is kind of a lackluster, if you can say so. All right, that's it for the Eevee packs. Now we have one pack left for this opening today, and that is from the new set of Lost Origin. I believe the American or English set is releasing here in the next few days, I believe the 9th. Japanese sets, but a few days though. It'd be cool to pull something on the one pack that I chose. All right, we got a Shuppet, Phantump, I believe that is, Whalmer, oh, and a shiny Shiftry. Not shiny, I apologize, holographic. And I think that's a Sunflora. That's cool though. The way the purple and greens and like teals kind of leak beyond the holographic frame, that's really cool. Shiftry, all right. Well, that is it for the packs I have for today. Got some good artwork, even though there weren't all that many rares, but I did get a couple really good shinies and full arts. I'm just going to do a little organization here, and we'll go over the pulls real quick. All right. So as far as Japanese go, we got that holographic Shiftry. These sleeves are kind of glaring in this light. I apologize. We got that full art Sylveon VMAX. Great pull. Holographic, I believe that's a floor, just I'll have to look it up. I promise I'll get better with the names of all the Pokemon. Alright, got that full art Rainbow Trainer. The shiny full art Grimmsnarl, it's another great one. The shiny Snom, still can't get over the look of that Pokemon, it's a little strange. Rolycoly shiny, another good one. Kyogre, amazing card. And then the holographic Indeedee. Not too bad for the amount of packs that I had. And like I said, hopefully in the future, accumulate a little bit more for each potential opening, and then, you know, a little bit more of each set instead of such a variety. But I think for a first video on this channel, it's kind of a cool experience to get a little bit of Japanese, some English, and some various packs. And then maybe down the road as well, I'll show as far as what my collection has accumulated so far before I decided to document and upload anything. Yeah, not too bad today. Again, my name is Actionpantz, and this is a brand new channel here, so if you did enjoy my video or any of the content that I end up putting on here, I'd appreciate a subscription, a like, you know, any of that good stuff, and follow along and see where we go. Again, appreciate you taking time out of your day to watch this video. You have a good one, and we'll see you next time.